Well, hey everybody, welcome to Rust Belt Pipes. Adam here, coming to you once again from Rust Belt Pipes HQ, shed in my backyard. It's a beautiful day today, about 40 degrees Fahrenheit, so I get the doors wide open. I have Charlie with me, so if you hear something, it's not a mouse, it's a 100-pound dog. This is going to be a long video, I'm going to tell you up front. So settle in, get yourself a pipe, get yourself a beverage, put your feet up, and enjoy this video. This is a auspicious day at Rust Belt Pipes for two reasons. First of all, after this video, it will be the very first day that Rust Belt Pipes is fully equipped to carve pipes, to produce pipes here at the bench. I'll have everything that I need, apart from like two things. And that is very exciting. It's thrilling. Several months after I had the initial idea of, hey, I think I'm actually gonna do this pipe carving thing, to be standing here at a bench, which very soon, not quite yet, but very soon we'll have everything that I need. So stay tuned in this video. We're gonna unbox a bunch of tools, we're gonna set up the lathe and talk through my thoughts on these things. So look forward to that. This is also an auspicious day because it represents the generosity of a very special group of people. You know who they are. It's the Rust Belt Pipes founding fathers. These are the folks who were willing to put up some money and help me basically make this video, make it possible, and make all of this possible here at Rust Belt Pipes. Genuinely, without them, there's no way that any of this could have happened so quickly. And so I'm eternally grateful to those folks. Thank you, founding fathers. Okay, now you can't see it, so I'm gonna move you to an action angle here. Down here is a box. In fact, you can't even quite see it. Down here is a box. The big one, that's the lathe. The small one has a bunch of stuff that we're going to use. Oh, so sorry. Has a bunch of stuff that we're also going to unbox. Okay. And the lathe is going to go here, just as a reminder. We're going to do the lathe last because we're going to unbox and set it up. So stay tuned. I'm going to move you back to this angle. I'm going to get things set up here and we'll get started. Again, make sure you've got a pipe and a beverage because this is not going to be short. See you in a minute. All right, and welcome back. So I have a box here, a giant box, and I'm gonna show you what's in the box one by one, just really quickly, and then we'll get to the lathe. So first of all, I got a rotary tool from Harbor Freight for Christmas, and it turns out after doing some testing on this piece of briar, it turns out, one, it's not great because it's battery powered, so it loses charge quickly, and it's not very powerful. So I picked up a Dremel. This is just a one step up from basic, but it will do everything that I want it to do. Most importantly, it's corded, which is nice. So I'll have reliable power. I also got for it, somewhere in here, a quick change collet, so I don't have to use the tool. It's a toolless chuck. Still learning the names of all these things. I had some calipers. They were digital, and being out here in the cold, they kind of crapped out. So I got an analog set, which is great. Another square, just to be extra covered. Got myself a Forstner bit for the size that I think I'm gonna be using most commonly, which is 19 mil. Of course, it goes down smaller, you know, but 19 mil. And then I got hardware to mount the lathe. So got some metal washers, I got some rubber washers to mitigate vibration, and I got our bolts. And this is just the same mounting hardware that I've used for all my other tools in here. That's what I picked up this morning when I couldn't do much else because my internet was down because we had a big ice storm, if you saw on Instagram. And in fact, you won't be able to see probably, but out here there's giant piles of wood because I was cleaning up the yard. Okay, then the rest of this is a mix of two boxes, one of which was from Vermont Freehand and the other from Rockler. So let's do Rockler first. I picked up a ton of these sandpaper rolls. These are 1 inch wide by 20 feet. And I got them in, do it in order, 240 grit, 320 grit, 400 grit, 600 grit. So these are nice. They're not belts like on the belt sander. They're just big rolls. So I can cut them to size what I need. I can hand sand with them. And most importantly, when I've got the pipe in the lathe rotating, I can cut a longer strip and just use it that way. So that's why I got that. Next, I got something very important. A chuck for the lathe. And I got the set. This is what's in here. I got the set because it has these pin jaws, which are going to be really nice for holding stems in. It's also, it doesn't have the bars to tighten. It's a key, which is great. And later down the road, my plan is to get a second chuck, not a full set, but just the chuck bit thing, and keep those pin jaws on there permanently. So I've got one chuck for briar and one chuck for stems, but that will be a real luxury. So further down the road. This is also stuff from Vermont Freehand, some slot tools for filing slots, some airway drill bits. These, I believe, are 5mm, which is probably larger than most people do. I think even Simon does 4. But I wanted to go a little bit larger because I like a good draw on my pipes. Pipe jaws. These, I am going to do it, put a guiding line on. This is not a line, that's the bag. Put a guide line on in the center, but these are the pipe jaws from Vermont Freehand. And finally, in this box, we've got a drill chuck and the, whatever this is called, Morse taper for lathe. Morse taper 2, which all everything is. So that's all of the stuff. And then a little ad about the Rockler guarantee. Okay, I'm going to put all this stuff back, and we're going to get to unboxing the lathe. That's really where things are going to get a little bit longer, because I'm going to actually install it here at the bench and put all this hardware on it. Be back in a minute. All right, so I've done the important bit of opening the box, and now we are going to make sure that we're doing everything correctly. Now, I have measured out this space here to fit. I'll just double check that. And yeah, more than enough space. It's 3 feet of usable space, and this should only take up 30 inches. By the way, this is, oh, new upgrade, by the way. this is the lathe that I purchased from Grizzly. Fantastic. Okay, so let's get it out of the box. You're as excited as I am, especially you founding fathers who really did make this possible. I'm so thrilled. Okay, let's keep going here. Environmentally sustainable styrofoam. Okay, so it looks like pretty much all one piece. Here we've got the tool rest and adjustment bar here. We've got feet, adjustable feet, wrenches, Allen keys, and looks like our live centers are in here. That's great. Actually, I'll leave this on so I can show you the bags. And the rest of it looks to be one giant piece. So, I'm going to be a little bit less than graceful. We have a lathe on the bench. La 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 la! Check it out. This is the lathe. Digital readout for RPM. Beautiful green color. And freshly manufactured because I had to wait for it. This is incredible. All right, so we've got tailstock. It's great, it locks. Yep. We've got, this is our speed control knob, which I believe attaches down here. We've got our tool rest holder here, which is sweet. A little bit of cosmoline stuff, so we'll clean that up once we've got it all assembled. Belt tensioner, I imagine. All right, well, I'm gonna get the manual out and figure out what I need to do next. So I know I said that I was going to mount it to the bench, but actually I really like these rubber feet that they have. So I'm gonna use these, and if I decide later that I wanna mount it to the bench, that's fine. But for now, feet. Okay, so that's all 4 feet on. Let's get it leveled up. All right, we're level that way. And we are pretty close. There we go. And we're level that way. Job done. On to the next thing. All right, new angle. Next step is attaching the speed control box, which is here. Just a couple of screws. So this is a pretty interesting thing. It's actually on a rod and a couple of eye bolt sort of looking things. So it doesn't actually attach to this. And there's this little hinge here. So you slap it on and then you, I assume, yeah, lock it down. That's pretty cool. Neat. Step 3.
Saint of pipe smokers.
Step 3 is over here at this end, attaching the handle with a flathead screwdriver. Pretty simple. Pretty nice. And you can't forget about the tool rest. That's pretty easy. All right, well, it looks like pretty much everything is ready to go. This is moving with my hand as it should. Everything's attached. Let's just check center real quick and then we'll get the new chuck and the pipe jaws on. So this should be pretty easy. In, yep, this goes in the other end. Yep, take the tool rest, move it over here. Move this up, moment of truth. How centered are we? I'd say that is pretty darn close. It actually is closer than it looks on camera. Spot on. Good on you, Grizzly. Okay, as a reminder, we're installing this chuck from Nova. I don't really know anything about lathe chucks. I picked Nova specifically because of the pipe jaws that Vermont Freehand has. It says in there that it mates well with Nova or One Way, I think is the other one. Anyway,
I picked these specifically for those, which we'll install here in a minute. But this is the one that we're doing first, G3 ProTech. It's a direct thread, which means it threads directly on to these threads, which are 8 TPI, which means 8 threads per inch. Okay, so it comes in a cool box like this. It's plastic, it's got a handle, and I've already kind of pulled a little bit of stuff out. So here is the chuck itself. Pretty weighty. This is a keyed chuck, which means that this controls the jaws rather than bars. Very thoughtfully, they put in a branded towel, microfiber cloth, to wipe stuff off with, because they do come with a little bit of grease already on them. So we'll wipe that off a bit, and this should just go right onto here. So let's just give it a whirl. Oh, and I'm doing this with my other hand here, see? I don't have magic powers yet. Okay, so this is good, right? Nice and solid on there. And what will happen is, because of the direction that this goes, because it spins towards me, it'll actually tighten as the thing is turned on. So it's not gonna come unthreaded and hit me in the face. So you can see here, as I mentioned before, this is keyed. This is the key, nice chunky key. And it goes in here, and this is what you use to, yeah, so you need to close or open the jaws, which is cool. Now, it does come with, as I mentioned, it comes with the regular, actually I'll show you in here. It comes with the regular jaw set here, but it also comes with these pin, what do they call them? Pin jaws, which have a very small circle. That will really fit a rod when I'm turning stems. But we're not gonna put that on today. We are gonna put on our new pipe jaws from Vermont Freehand. So these are the jaws, and we're just gonna put them right on here. Comes with some thumb screws and some set screws. Now, I went with these just to start. They are much more affordable than some of the other ones that you'll see. Certainly the like real professional carvers use. Those are much more expensive, but these jaws will work just fine. They're gonna look like this when they're on the thing. You can tighten them or widen them to suit the briar. And they have really nice sharp teeth here. And you'll see in a minute, there's a hole here for pins you can put in there to allow the briar to rotate while staying centered. Anyway, we'll get through all of this as pipes actually start coming off this bench. But for now, let's just get it on here. Okay, so we're ready to do this. Now, how do you install these? Well, there's two mounting holes. And so what's gonna happen is these are gonna end up here and here, basically. Two holes on the bottom, but you can only see one hole there. The other hole, in there. So what we're gonna do is we've got a small one, which fits all the way down in. So we'll use an Allen key, a long one, and get in there and tighten it. And then the other one should be just fine to tighten with a shorter one. So let me find those tools. Well, I didn't have to walk very far. Here they are. We just will find the one that fits and use that. All right, so let's go ahead and do this. I got the right tool. So the long one is gonna go down in here and we'll get that, see it poking out the bottom. We'll just get this sort of tight, but not too tight. Short one goes in here. Yep. All right, so there's the first one. This is exciting. Let's get the second one on. And I should say, you know, why am I specifically doing this? Well, it's because I've not seen anyone else show how this is done. And so I sort of had to figure it out by watching many different videos. But this way, when somebody wants to carve pipes and they go, how do you attach these jaws? Oh, you could just watch this video. Okay, so there we go. Now, should be able to do a pretty neat opening and closing of the jaws here. Right? Oh, there they go, closed. Yep, and here they are, open. Awesome. Okay, I'm going to get the stuff for the drill chuck here in the tailstock and flip you around.
All right, well,
I've got you down here at the other end. Hey there. And we're going to replace this kind of live center thing with drills or a drill chuck. So lathes are interesting. I've never used a lathe. This is really like we're going to be blazing a trail here for myself. They're interesting because they use this Morse taper thing, which is a metal bit that goes in here. And there's no, like, I can't pull that out because it's such a tight, exact connection. So try as I might, this thing is not going to come. This rotates, but I can't pull it out. So what you have to do, apparently, back it out until it pushes it. There we go. Right? That's pretty cool. So you can see that it's very slightly tapered. Which, in order to mount my drill chuck, I have to buy a thing. This is all from Rockler. Right, so this is what we've got. And this is just like you have in a hand drill. You know, it opens up and closes, which will be sweet. You'd actually do it with the key in this hole here. Put the key in and turn. Anyway, but as you can see, this, nothing to mate up with. That's what the taper's for. What we can do is do that, and they say to hit it on the back end just once firmly, and that mates the pieces. And so now I've got a drill chuck, and put this out a little bit. This should go in. Yep, and I'm pulling on it. And it's not coming out, so that's a good sign. But if I pull back this out, there it goes. All right, so that tells us that this is about as far as we can go. Okay, so now when I drill, you know, you do this, just spinning it on the wheel behind. And you can lock it with this thing, but why would you want to? Okay, let me flip us around again, and yeah, we'll turn it on. All right, so it's plugged in. I'm just gonna get out of the way and turn it on. Let's try it. Oh, that's so cool. So this is on a low speed.
So let me show you. It's showing 200 and a bit RPM. 96, and if I dial it up a little bit, it's 500. Yeah. Let's go up a bit more. 600, 650.
Oh, that's super cool. All right. Well, I'd say that works. Getting a shaking somewhere in here. It's these jaws, the attachment. So I need to tighten that up a little bit. But I think that works. So.
Well, here we are at the bench. I couldn't be more grateful. This really means a lot, so thank you again to all the Founding Fathers. Thanks to everyone who watched this and my other videos. Stay tuned, because I'm going to start making pipes, like, this weekend. See you guys. Thanks for dropping by.